so far, so I wanted to make a video and talk about some of my thoughts, and we'll do a little bit of gameplay as well. So please sit back and get cozy and enjoy some whispered Zenless Zone Zero gameplay exploration with me. So we are currently playing as Belle. This is the female main character, but the thing one of the initial things that I love about this game is that you are actually not particularly tied into the main character that you play, so you can actually swap siblings. And unlike Genshin or Honkai, where in Genshin's case you have a sibling but you are looking for them, so they are very much not playable, or in Honkai's case where whichever character you pick, the other one just doesn't exist, this game has both characters in it. They both whichever one you don't pick, you interact with pretty much all the time. And I don't know, I love that. I love that you have that immediate emotional connection to another character. And I think Wise is really cool. Obviously, I picked Belle because I tend to pick female characters. I love her design. I think she just looks so, so cute. Kind of not necessarily cyberpunk aesthetic, but just very futuristic style that she's got going on. I love her little chunky trainers. I think they're adorable. Oh my gosh, I've never seen this picture of her. It's so cute. It's Wise and Belle, and this where we're starting out is the video store that the two of them own. Stay. to our bedroom is very messy. Again, it kind of matches up to her personality. So she's the younger sister. She's a little bit more kind of impulsive, a little bit more chaotic. And yeah, her room is quite messy. optimized art rail in that sense. And I think as long as the areas are interesting, I don't mind if they're somewhat closed off, but I want to go through my characters now. I keep opening the tab by accident. I will go through the characters that I have. It's fairly generous in terms of the wishes that they're giving out, like, to new players. So, I think I've done, what is it? 46. Okay, so I'm like, what is that? I'm kind of halfway to Pity on the standard banner, which is 90. Is that saying I've done 90? No, that can't be right. I've done 92 wishes on the standard banner. Okay, that is a lot. You apparently get 92 wishes for free. And I'm not like, I'm spending my Primo Gem type currency on the limited wishes. Like, I've not bought any of the standard wishes with that. Now, I'm not interested in getting Ellen. I'm going to save up for someone in the future. I'm not sure who yet, but I'm not like super sold on her design or her playstyle, so at the moment I'm just saving these limited ones and then wishing on the standard as much as I can. So I've actually gotten 2 5 stars from the standard. I got in my first 10 pull, I got this character, which is Rina. This is Alexandrina Sebastian. Now, she is from the Victoria Housekeeping Company. Now, I've not met this character yet, or any of the Victoria Housekeeping, apart from one of them that you meet kind of earlier on. Now, what I really like about this game is that you have these different factions, kind of, and you get combat buffs from having, like, multiple members of the faction in a team together. I just think that's really interesting, because not only do you have, like the standard guy, you got electric, fire, physical, like, the damage type, and then you've got, like, support, offensive, defensive, I think, I can't quite remember the exact terms, but I like that you have that extra thing as well. I suppose it's kind of like the elemental resonance in Genshin. But yeah, I don't know, I think it's just fun. She is a electric support. She's interesting. She's kind of like a ghost, I don't know, but like she floats in her gameplay. She calls down lightning. She's pretty cool. I think she's quite good combat-wise, but I've not been playing her very much.
Nothing to
is that in our description maybe, and be the original member of Gentle House. According to the new Eridu resident records, her identity as Anbi Damara only exists after joining Gentle House, the name obviously being taken from Nicole. Okay, yeah, so they're not actually siblings. Before registering as an employee of Gentle House, all data relating to Anbi is suspiciously blank. Despite her extreme lack of common sense, Anbi is well versed in matters related to combat and is among the strongest combatants of the Cunning Hares. Anbi's greatest interest is movies, of which she likes an extensive range of genres. Due to an excessive obsession, she tends to take the stories in movies as reality. Contrary to her seemingly emotionless appearance, Anbi is easily moved by movie storylines. Her favourite food is hamburgers because they contain protein, carbs, and greens, taste good, and are even affordable. There's nothing else besides hamburgers. Belle says Anbi often comes to the video store to borrow movies and returns them quickly, so she seems to watch a lot of movies. Feeling the pressure, bro. As the manager of the video rental store, it'd be embarrassing if the amount of movies we watch falls behind our customers. Y says, honestly, I'm most curious about Ambi's playlist. She's got her headphones on constantly, but what exactly is she listening to? Interesting. I do like Anbi. I'm not sure, like, I never really like those characters that don't have much going on personality-wise. Like, Nicole is just so fun and, like, I don't know, just interesting. But hopefully Anbi will learn more about her. So I feel like those are kind of all the characters that I really like. And then the other characters that I've gotten is Piper Wheel. She's part of the Sons of Caledon. Now, I've never met these characters. I don't know anything about them. Visually, I don't really know. I'm not interested in how she looks. Like, yeah, she just looks like a child, so. And then we have Corin. I keep clicking that, thinking that's, like, how you open them up. This is Corin Wicks. She is from Victoria Housekeeping Company as well. She's a physical attack character. She just looks like Owawa from Onkastariel, but yeah, I don't know. She's also like that like shy archetype, which I literally do not care for. This is Luciana de Montepio. She's also from the Sons of Caledon. Yeah, so again, I know nothing about this character. I've not tried out them combat-wise. She's a fire support, apparently. But yeah, so those are all of the characters that I've gotten. I was really hoping to get this below. This is one icon that I sadly not get him for my first 5-star. Now listen, hear me out. I'm not a fairy, but this guy, I mean, I'm not gonna say anything more. I actually, after playing her in the story, I really want Nekomata. She's also from the Cunning Hares. She was really fun. And Soldier 11, her character is kind of boring to me, but her playstyle was really good. And then, oh yeah, so we've got Ellen. As I said, not really interested in getting her. And Grace, I would love to get Grace because I think she would be really good with Anton. She's like a shock support, I think. kitchen in the city, I'll share a part of it with you. There is no way that Nena means all of that. Nana knew. By the way, did you happen to see the rude person who took my treasure detector? When I arrived, all I saw was you lying there. Searching for treasures in the neighborhood, and he suddenly came at me, clenched his teeth around my detector, and wouldn't let go. Nanu, but thank you for your timely help in getting me back on my feet. I believe that rude person mustn't have gone far. I'll go look for him. Okay. Have we got any other quests? I'm currently just, so... So, currently, I'm just on the main quest, Chapter 2, A Call from the Hollow's Heart, and all I have to do currently is get my internaut level to 26, and I am on 24, so at the moment, I'm just doing side quests to get my level up, which is why I was like, oh, perfect time to make a video, because obviously, I like doing the main story is kind of hard. You shouldn't watch horror movies before you go out walking at night. Yep. Here's Officer Mew Mew. Hey there, kind citizen. Want to keep track of your community contributions? This one is like... these are kind of like mini objectives that you can turn in. So this was timely assistance medical for the ex-treasure hunt Bangboo to earn this medal.
Assignment, but why isn't the coffee here yet?
cheese cookies. Cheese cookies. But they're not very nutritious, and for the same price, you can get a big bag of pickled seaweed. You're going on a spring trip. You don't get it. I've been eating toast for 4 days straight. Mum bought a load of toast and told me I'd be having all kinds of toast for the next week. Plain toast for breakfast and toast with vegetable soup for dinner for 4 days straight. I can't handle any more toast, seriously. I've got to grab some proper food while my mum is busy watching TV. Alright, let's see. Got my wallet. What's this? It's not a denny and doesn't look like a Godfinger token. This is an HIA commemorative coin. Do you want it? Any amount of dennies is fine. Please help a starving soul out. I'll give you 300 dennies for it. Awesome. Thanks, miss. Oh yeah, so we get these coins to give to a trash can. Don't question it. Here's the 24-hour store. 141. I still not really understood what these things sell. I guess I should probably buy all of it. Well, like, because it refreshes in a day. I think it just kind of looks like level up material. Let's buy it. Attack component. Molded blonding agent. Not enough bang booze, oh no. Yeah, I mean, I've got quite a lot of money, so might as well. Advanced ether chip. Reinforced stun component. Crystallized plating agent. Sure, let's take that. Oh, I missed Godfinger. Is that what the place is called? This is the arcade. That's really fun. You can play like Snake. And there's another game which I'm not sure what it's based on. Hey look, these three bamboos are so adorable. It's not part of my shop door, but consider it additional content for my vlog. The one in the middle must be nearsighted. It's holding the board close to see properly. Oh, they're so adorable. I want to keep them as pets. Ah, what are you talking about? We could be your pets, dear Clara. Oh, this is so embarrassing. That's so cursed. Designs as well. Like, we've got old characters, we've got like working dressed people, like dressed in office wear, people dressed kind of like fancy, dressed like they're going to a club. We've got a bang boo statue here, and then we've got, what's this place, Box Galaxy. Oh, this sounds like gadget store. Oh, okay, so this place sells, these are called W engines. I think they're basically weapons. Yeah, I've not really got many of them, but. And then down here is the metro. I don't think this actually leads to anything, but I've not really unlocked many other areas in the city, so I don't quite know. Oh, I love this, like, sunset view. That looks so pretty. But maybe we will head back, and I'm gonna go and do a commission. We got random play. What do we got in the window? Loads of TVs. I do like the implication that at some point in the future, like this futuristic world, see like the flip thing that she does. Oh, there you go. Ben like appears in on screen and she does a flip off of his thing. I can't, still don't know what to call it. Oh, then we got an ultimate. And here you have these switch out skills where when you bring someone special ability. Just so fun. Oh, there we go. That was easy. We did that very quickly. Mission complete. Yeah. You're back, Belle. How was your day? Feeling a bit worn out? Cut yourself some slack, Belle. It doesn't hurt to take a break. If we can wrap up that job for Billabook Industries soon and get the final payment, we'll be able to breeze through this month. It's a shame that we have yet to hear anything about the third mission machine. It's a pile driver, isn't it? I wonder what kind of problem job this pile driver will turn out to be. Let's hope it won't be too tricky to deal with. Anyway, let's just rest for today. We're sure to be busy once we hear from Billabook Industries again. Good night, Belle. Good night, Wise. Go rest on the sofa. I don't know why they always go to sleep on the sofa. For some reason, the sofa looks particularly soft today. Fatigue is the best sleeping pill. Yeah, let's go to bed. You rest comfortably, and now your mind feels exceptionally clear. This must be your knock-knock account, right, Miss Independent Investigator? Great, now I can contact you directly. Your name looks familiar. This is Ray from White Star Institute. We worked together for at Scott Outpost, remember? You forgot about me, or are you just playing dumb? Well, playing dumb won't help, because I've got a new commission for you. Oh, here we go again. Another headache of a job. In New Eridu, you can't escape death, hollows, and work. Death and taxes. Just the way it is. With someone as capable as you, I've got to leverage your skills to the fullest. Meet me at Scott Outpost when you have time. We need to talk about this in person. Scott Outpost, it's a job connected to Hollow Zero. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna do that. I'm going to ignore that and carry on with my side quests. What time of day is it at the moment? Okay, so it is the morning now. See if I can do this one called Fluffy Trouble. Cause I'm curious what that means. I'm hoping that it involves cats. Let's track that one. Oh, can I not track it? Okay, I'm confused. I can't track that quest, but I don't know if I'm just like stuck in this quest. I hope not. Combat is what I wanted she does. It's cool. Very satisfying. Okay, there we go. We collected all of the data. I was also quite quick. We did it in under 4 minutes, Daddy. Nice. Can I get out of this other one yet? I don't know if it will let me. I think it's gonna like force me to be stuck in this quest. So much for watching.